Hello everyone, this is my actually third video on Gulliver's travels, and as I've already said that I have discussed with you regarding the background aspects of Gulliver's travels. I've discussed with you that how Jonathan Swift's Gulliver's travels is a satire on the human nature. It's a virulent and scathing satire upon the entire humanity. I also discussed about you regarding the various socio-political background of the contemporary England, about the Whig and the Tory party. I discussed about you the conflict between the two different religious denominations of England, between the Protestant as well as Catholic Church. I also discussed about the tremendous political and social significance of Reformation, and how English Reformation or British Reformation is different in its scope and effect from the European Protestant Reformation. I discussed about you the basic background of Restoration literature. I also discussed in which year Gulliver Travels was published in 1726, and how and who was Gulliver. Gulliver was born in Nottinghamshire. He was a surgeon come traveler. I also discussed about the very brief framework of Gulliver's travels, about the basic framework of the Gulliver's travel, about the basic storyline of into the voyage of the land of the Lilliput and voyage into the land of the Brobdingnagian, and also about the voyage into the land of the Laputa, Balnibarbi, Lagnag, Glavdrabdib and Japan, and into the voyage of the land of the Whims. And I said that only two books, the book one and the book two, the book that describes about the voyage into the land of the Lilliput and voyage into the land of the Brobdingnagians, are into your syllabus. So in this particular video lecture, I said that I'll begin with a brief chapter summary, as well as at the same time I will also discuss about the text, about the important lines of the text. So let us begin with the chapter summary of the book one, of a voyage to the land of the Lilliput. So as I've already said, that there is a recurrent theme which is running throughout the entire text of Gulliver's Travels, and this theme is that of the Gulliver being actually facing a kind of a form of accident in the sea, and then due to this accident he is facing various forms of new creatures, various gruesome and grotesque creatures, and this recurrent pattern is occurring throughout the entire text. So in the book one, the chapter one, on this voyage, Gulliver goes to the sea as a surgeon on the merchant ship Antigone. Remember, this kind of question can come: what's the name of the ship in which Gulliver commences his first voyage to the land of the Lilliput? So to answer that, it is the ship of the Antigone. The ship is destroyed during a heavy windstorm, and Gulliver, the only survivor, swims to a nearby island, the island of that of the Lilliput. And being nearly exhausted from the ordeal, he falls asleep, and upon awakening, he finds that the island's inhabitants were no longer than 6 inches tall. So for the first time, discovered in the land of the Lilliput that these Lilliputians are only 6 inches tall, who have captured him. And after examination, they have provided Gulliver with food, and the emperor of this country orders his subject to move Gulliver to a little used temple, the only large enough space to house this huge body of Gulliver. Now, from this particular chapter, there are some critical comments or critical remark that I have to make. First of all, in this very first chapter, Swift establishes Gulliver's character, because the introductory chapter is a very important key chapter through which a novelist or an author establishes or introduces the character. And he does this primarily by the vast amount of details that he tells us about Gulliver. And clearly, Gulliver is good and solid character, but he is very much unimaginative, typically British character who is unimaginative. At least an Irishman like Jonathan Swift created a typical Englishman like Gulliver in this way, in a very gullible way. Okay, he is born in Nottinghamshire, a seated country without any form of eccentricity and imaginative characteristic. And Gulliver, the name of the Gulliver alludes to his gullibility. So he believes what he is told. He's an honest man and he expects others to be honest. At least ei rokom bhabe Gulliver er character take create kora hoyeche ei particular book e, ei book 1 e Gulliver's travels er voyage to the land of the Lilliput. Ami bar bar bolchi, the character of the Gulliver will eventually change. The character of the Gulliver will eventually transform. He is not a flat character. He is rather a dynamic character who will constantly change himself. So this changeability is a very important motif in Gulliver's character. And Gulliver does not always understand the meaning of in which he is always put into. The result is a series of astonishingly detailed and deadpan scenes, because Gulliver gradually discovers, moving from one exact detail to another, that he is a prisoner of men who are 6 inches tall. So in this way, for the first time, Jonathan Swift introduces Gulliver as a kind of prisoner in the land of the Lilliput. In the very second chapter, in this chapter, the imperial majesty, that is the emperor of the land of the Lilliput and Gulliver, they engage themselves on a conversation as best they can, because there is always this form of linguistic problem. Language as a form of communication, Gulliver's travels emerge question, because they are speaking in two different languages. But Gulliver will eventually learn the language of the emperor. Eta amra ekhane bujhte parbo. After the emperor's visit, 6 Lilliputians shoot arrows at Gulliver, and Gulliver retaliates by pretending to eat the little archers and then releases them. This clemency and Gulliver's cooperation impresses the imperial council. Bujhlo na e shotru noy, amader khoti korbe na. So they have a debate regarding whether to free Gulliver or not to free Gulliver. An officer takes inventory of Gulliver's possessions, which will be held until Gulliver's fate is settled upon. So, second chapter, it's a critical comment. First, Swift makes the Lilliputians seem ridiculous by having Gulliver compared to them to dolls. The little doll-like men strut and prostitute and posture like full-sized men, yet we cannot take them seriously. And the emperor's face clearly resembles to that of George I. George I ke dekhte khub eta bhalo chilo na, kintu ekhane somehow handsome holeo ei emperor ke. George I was notoriously gross and ugly, kintu Swift alludes that perhaps there is a hidden allusion amra bujhte parchi between the George I and the emperor. Swift is satirizing here the evidence presented against Hardy and Bolingbroke. Amra pore jante parbo Hardy ebong Bolingbroke kara. এই পার্টিকুলার নভেলের ক্ষেত্রে রেলিভেন্স কী, তাদেরকে কনস্ট্যান্টলি রিলেট করছে একটা পলিটিক্যাল স্যাটায়ার ক্রিয়েট করার জন্য সুইফট এই পার্টিকুলার টেক্সট। নাও চ্যাপ্টার 3, ইন দিস পার্টিকুলার চ্যাপ্টার, চ্যাপ্টার 3, দ্য লিলিপুটিয়ান এম্পারার ইজ প্লিজড দ্যাট গালিভার ইজ ফ্রেন্ডলি and cooperative, and so he rewards him with some court diversions, that is various court entertainments. The diversions, however, prove to be quite different than that one might expect. It is the Lilliputian court custom that men seeking political office demonstrate their agility in rope dancing, among other things. So for the first time we are introduced with various court customs, with various court rituals. What are the court rituals? In this case, that are the rope dancing. Rope dancing mane, it will eventually will prove your ability to balance, it will eventually prove your ability of agility. Tumi kotota flexible sob kichur shonge maniye nite parcho ki parcho na, kotota tumi king ke ba raja ke khushi korte parcho. Phole political office grabbing ba political office dokholer khatirer jonno kemon kore tomake ekjon skillful rope dancer hote hobe. How long and how skillfully a candidate can dance upon a rope determines his tenure in the office. So eventually the art of oiling, eventually the art of keeping those people who are in power, keeping happy of those people in power, ei je concept ta amader samaje ekhono chole asche seta 18th century court e seta 18th century society te koto relevant chilo tai niye chapter 3 discuss korche of Gulliver's travels. So of the candidates who two are particularly adept, dujon ottonto important candidate ekhane emerge korbe. One is Rail Russell, who will eventually become Gulliver's friend, and another is Filmer the treasurer, who is not at all a very good character. And other diversions include noblemen competing for official favor by crawling under or leaping under a particular feat, for which they are then rewarded with various colored beads. And Gulliver also reviews the emperor's troops. He stands legs apart with the tiny men who are marching through them. So that's the summary of chapter 3. I should also talk about certain critical comments associated with this particular chapter. As I've already said, the rope dancing itself actually shows the agility or the skill with which the men in the court can keep the emperor happy. So the jumping and the crawling games that Gulliver describes sound innocent, but they are like games the children might play. So politically, however, their significance is far from innocent. These games are very politically important, because the crawlers and the jumpers perform for the amusement of the monarch and are rewarded with blue, red and green threads. These threads actually represent the various orders of the garter, the bath and the thistle. Jerokom bhabe shoiniker kono ekjon boro shoinik she colonel kina ba she ekjon major kina, ei hierarchy ba rank ta amra kibhabe bujhte pari, tar particular colors in their dresses, in their costume. Sherokom bhabei various threads representing various orders, orders of garter, bath, these are the names of the various places, and thistle, ei guloke ei colored threads represent korto. George the First used these orders as cheap ways of buying political support from the social climbers, and politicians, Swift is saying, are always ready to debase themselves by performing into these humiliating games, hoping for colored ribbons, money or titles. Phole prothom thekei khubi kharap bhabe ei political ritual guloke, political custom, various political games eguloke reveal korar chesta korche through various acts of rope dancing and others. Eguloke Swift reveal korar chesta korche. Swift's model for film nap, the most dexterous and perhaps the most dangerous of the rope dancers, is Robert Walpole. The leader of the Whigs, Walpole was generally considered as the first prime minister in the modern sense of England, and he was an extremely wily politician. So this is a very important question, je film nap ke kon particular political character er model e Swift create korar chesta korechen. Robert Walpole, the leader of the Whigs as Gulliver's Travels, is an anti-Whig satire, and hence the character of the novel Walpole was created and molded out of the character of the film. The character of the film now is created out of the character of the Robert Walpole, who was the first prime minister in the modern sense and an extremely wily politician, who resigned in 1717 but was restored to the office 4 years later through influence of the Duchess of the Kendale. Duchess of the Kendale through the our office emerged for him. The Duchess was his mistress, and figuratively is the cushion on which film map breaks his fall. Walpole was not a pro-war whip, but he did use war sentiment to retain power. কিন্তু সুইফট নিজে ভয়ঙ্করভাবে ঘৃণা করতেন টু ইউজ ওয়ার্ড সেন্টিমেন্টস টু রিটেন পাওয়ার অ্যান্ড প্রাইভেটলি হি বিলিভ দ্যাট ইংল্যান্ড প্রসপেক্ট বেটার আন্ডার পিস দ্যান ওয়ার। যদিও ওয়ালপোল নিজে বিশ্বাস করতেন যে পিসে অনেক বেশি পরিমাণে ইংল্যান্ড প্রসপেক্ট করে, বাট হি ইউজ দিস প্রো সেন্টিমেন্ট প্রো ওয়ার্ড সেন্টিমেন্ট ইন অর্ডার টু ক্লাইম থ্রু দ্য সোশ্যাল ল্যাডার। সো ইট ইজ থট দ্যাট রেল রেসল দ্য সেকেন্ড মোস্ট ডেক্সটারাস অফ দ্য রোপ ডান্সার্স is either Count Viscount or the Count Tunshent or Lord Carteret. Both were political allies of Robert Walpole. তাদের অত্যন্ত কাছের পলিটিক্যাল অ্যালাইজ ছিল। রেল রেসল যদিও এখানে গালিভারের বন্ধু বা গালিভারের ফ্রেন্ড হিসেবে ডেপিক্টেড হয়েছে। সো উই উইল ইভেঞ্চুয়ালি কাম ইন্টু চ্যাপ্টার ফোর, বাট বিফোর অ্যাপিয়ারিং ইন্টু চ্যাপ্টার ফোর let us introduce with the characters of the book one. Who are the important characters? First is of course Captain Lemuel Gulliver, who is the traveler and adventurer, who is the protagonist of the travels. Then a very big name, we perhaps don't want to pronounce his name, Galvasto Momaren Evelyn Gurdilo Chefin Muli Uligu, the emperor of the Lilliput, je raja tar eto boro nam. Swift uses emperor as an example of the rulers who must always have some type of support before making a decision. Then there is film map. Film map is the Lord High Treasurer of Lilliput. Film map is the Lord High Treasurer of Lilliput. Mone thakbe short question e kintu porar khubi sombhabona. Who is film map? And then there is Red Dressel. Rail Dressel is a Lilliputian counselor. He is the principal secretary of private affairs. Principal secretary of private affairs. Very another important character. And then there is Skyresh Bolgolam. Will be introduced with this character. He is a high admiral of Lilliput, a counselor of the emperor, Skyresh Bolgolam. And then there are two parties. These two political parties, perhaps suggestive of the Whigs and the Tories. Slamsican and Tramsican. Slamsican and Tramsican, TRAMECKSAN. Slamsican and Tramsican, Lilliputian political parties. The first represents the low heels, the second represents the high heels. So first perhaps can represent as at the word low, it can suggest that of the Whigs, and Tramsican that of the Tories. So these are the characters who are very important characters in the first book of Gulliver's Travels. Then we will move into the summary of the chapter 4 of Gulliver's Travels.